island of Malta, European Union, sometime late in 2016. Businessman Jorgen Fennick explodes in rage after reading a blog.
Enough! I want this Daphne woman dead!
And summoned his trusted aide, Melvin Thuma.
Call in the Di Giorgio brothers.
Boys, we need to meet. Boss has a job for you.
Fenich's man Thuma gives an advance to the Di Giorgio brothers.
Here is 30,000 euro. Rest 120,000 you will get after the work is done.
Vidinija, Malta, Daphne Caruana Galizia's country house. Night of October 15, 2017.
Keep a watch if anyone comes.
They place a bomb under a charcoal grey Peugeot 108 parked inside the compound. At 3 p.m. the next day, as their target Daphne sits in a car and turns on the ignition.
She's left the house.
They activate the bomb. Hearing the explosion, Daphne's son Matthew, himself a Pulitzer Prize winning journalist, runs out of the front door of his house, barefoot, where on the dirt gravel road, he sees fire flaring from his mother's burning car.
Bomb!
53-year-old Daphne was an investigative journalist whose blog running commentary drew more readers than the circulation of all of Malta's newspapers combined. At the time of her death, she was tracking at least three stories that showed massive corruption in Malta. With the needle of suspicion pointing straight to Prime Minister Joseph Muscat's office and his close circle, including businessman Jorgen Fennich, who was especially favored by the PM and awarded rights to build a massive power station and supply gas to the island country. Which they did via a via-via scheme using Azerbaijan's state oil company Sokar, who first bought gas from Shell for $113 million and then sold it to Electrogas Malta for $153 million. A company in which they themselves were partners along with Fenich's company and Germany's Siemens. Electrogas then supplied this gas to Malta's main utility company Enmalta for exactly the same price at which they had bought it, $153 million. Enmalta then converted this gas into electricity and distributed it to the citizens of Malta. So on the surface, it seems that Electrogas is supplying gas to Enmalta without keeping a penny of profit. But actually, $40 million has already been siphoned off even before the gas reaches Enmalta. Of this, $2 million ends up in two Panama-based offshore companies via Fenich's Dubai-based firm 17 Black. In 2016, Daphne blew the lid on these Panama companies, which turned out to be secretly owned by none other than the PM's right-hand men, Secretary of State Keith Shembri and Energy Minister Conrad Mizzi. To scare her into silence, Daphne had been attacked several times earlier. Her pet dog was found dead with its neck slit. Her house was set on fire. And she received regular death threats on social media. Even her son Andrew was fired from his diplomatic job in India. Did she go too far this time? And did her discovery of kickbacks and corruption within the Prime Minister's circle put the last nail in the coffin of Malta's most outspoken and fearless journalist? With a population of just more than 450,000, Malta is the youngest and smallest member of the European Union, but has recently gained from the problems in other nations. The 2013 banking crisis in Cyprus made Malta an alternative financial haven. Arab Spring prompted many European tourists to choose nearby Maltese beaches over Tunisia. Brexit will also advance Malta's effort to promote itself as a safe, low-tax, English-speaking jurisdiction firmly inside the bloc. It sells hundreds of passports at $1.5 million each to wealthy foreigners looking to buy citizenship as a backdoor entry to the EU. But it has also become Europe's main hub for online gambling, many sites being owned by Fenich himself. So while Malta has become richer, it has also become more corrupt. Daphne exposed this seamy side and was silenced. Continuous protests went on for a year after her so-called accident.
Go, Muscat, go!
Forcing the government over a year later in December 2017 to appease them by arresting the three hitmen, but leaving the real culprits untouched. Yet the protests didn't stop. In a show of defiance by the government, in November 2019, the Maltese army locked peaceful protesters in Parliament House. This act got the EU to take notice.
We must appoint a delegation to investigate Daphne's death.
And sent a parliamentary delegation to Malta.
The Prime Minister of Malta should resign if he hinders the investigation.
Soon the actual culprit was identified. But he tried to escape after receiving a tip-off from no less than the Prime Minister's Chief of Staff, Keith Chembri.
The police has identified you in Daphne's murder. Get out of the country soon.
But Fenech was not swift enough.
Mr. Fenech, you are under arrest.
When his boss was caught, Fenech's aide Melvin Thuma knew he was next and tried to run as well.
What is this? Why so much cash?
During police interrogation, Thuma sang like a canary.
I will tell you everything about Daphne Galizia's murder, but to get me a presidential pardon.
Thuma's confession opened up a can of worms for Fenech, Chembri, Mizzi and Cardona. The ministers had to resign and were interrogated. And though named in the murder, they were not charged. But Prime Minister Joseph Muscat still acted as if he could get away untouched, briefly locking up some 100 journalists in a room.
You can't run away from our questions.
And went on the counter-offensive.
The Galizia family is trying to tarnish my image.
But after much pressure from the public and the EU, Muscat finally resigned in January 2020. The freedom of press and journalists are becoming easy targets of corrupt politicians. Be it Jamal Khashoggi of Saudi Arabia, Ilham Tohti, the Chinese writer serving a life sentence, Esra Abdel Fateh, Egyptian journalist on hunger strike, tortured and hospitalized, or Alexandr Valov, the Russian journalist whose whereabouts are still unknown. Daphne's murder led to 18 international media organizations forming the Daphne Project that takes forward the stories she was working on. Bisbo is proud to support them. Bisbo's limerick. There was a journalist from Malta who in her investigative work did not falter. But the people she exposed believed a threat she posed and killed her in order to halt her. Subscribe to Bisbo and click on the bell icon to get notified whenever Bisbo releases a new video. Sources of all our information is listed in the video description section.